Hey fellas, it's me, Rika, back at again with another Roblox game review. We love these things. They're great and good and awesome. You probably noticed I sound a little bit excited because today is actually a really big day. You wanna know why it's a big day? That's right, because I'm actually reviewing a game on Roblox I like. The what? So you really can't shame me for being a little bit excited, okay? I want to talk about this. Even if this game in particular is just a little bit on the flawed side. And by a little bit, I mean a lot on the flawed side, but I still love it, okay? The question that has obviously popped into your head, what game is being reviewed? Yeah, that's it. That's a good question, and you are very smart and observant. So, in order to answer that question, I actually need to get my trusty hacking keyboard to type out the name of the game for me. That's how it works around here now. Uh-oh. Here we are. Flee the Facility, that's the game we're reviewing today, whether you like it or not. Listen to me, buddy. Whether you like it or not, that's the game we're reviewing, okay? If you got a problem with that, you can click off this video.
I need to calm down. We're gonna talk about it now.
Huh? Uh-oh, looks like we've got a live update coming in. It turns out that a new update to Flee the Facility was just released, and it fixes almost all of the problems I was originally going to talk about. I'm not sure whether I should be angry or if I should be rejoicing. Some of these problems include being able to walk around as a ragdoll, being able to drop your hammer as the beast, being able to easily use exploits. Psych! This update made the game even more broken! Okay, let's not get ahead of ourselves here. What even is Flee the Facility? It's not like you'd find much out from playing the game yourself, since there's no tutorial whatsoever, despite the game desperately needing one. In Flee the Facility, there are 4 survivors and 1 beast. As a survivor, you need to work with your team to hack 5 computers in order to activate 2 exits on the map, open them up, and escape the facility. As the beast, you're supposed to do the opposite of that, I guess. Through the use of your hammer and a singular special ability that allows you to run faster, you need to stop the survivors from completing their objective by hitting them with the hammer, grabbing them with your rope, and capturing them. When captured, a survivor's health slowly goes down, and they need to rely on a teammate to come free them. The core concept is pretty great, but this brings us to a frequently recurring problem. It's not fleshed out at all. I will cut the creator some slack, as this game is still in beta, but some aspects of this just aren't excusable. These same 3 maps are the only ones that have been available to play throughout the game's entire lifetime, which is nearly 6 months at this point. If you're not going to add any new maps, then at least provide us with a map kit so we can submit some. I'd be more than happy to help. That's not the only thing that makes this game bland, though. The biggest issue I have with this is hacking computers. Calling it monotonous would be an understatement. You press the E key once while standing in front of one of the keyboards, and occasionally a QuickTime event will pop up where you have to press E again when the red line enters the white area. If you do this incorrectly, you'll get an error, which will alert the beast of your location. Considering this is the primary thing you're going to be doing as a survivor, it gets just a little bit tedious. If the QuickTime events were more frequent and there were a great variety of tasks to perform when hacking, it would be so much more engaging than what we have now. Maybe you would need to type out a certain line of code before time runs out, or press buttons in a specific order. I don't know, it can't be that hard to come up with ideas for it. Then comes the balancing issues. Clearly, being the beast is supposed to be the fun thing that everyone looks forward to, as you can literally pay to increase your chances of being the beast, but in practice, it's incredibly annoying to play as. This comes from a multitude of things. For starters, your abilities as the beast are extremely limited, as the only perk currently available in the game is Runner. Different perk options would make the beast infinitely more interesting to play as. Again, coming up with ideas for this cannot be difficult. How about an ability that would temporarily allow you to crouch like a survivor? Maybe an ability that would briefly allow you to see where everyone on the map is? Just give us something to work with, please. That's not all that makes the beast incredibly unfun, though. I really hate the way that every time you jump, your walk speed is set so low that you're pretty much helpless for a few seconds. Why is this a thing? Everything is already so far in the survivor's favor, yet you can't allow the beast to jump normally? I mean, seriously, you can literally just crouch under a table and the beast can't get you at all. all. You're just invincible. And don't even get me started on the bugs. There are so many simple glitches that are either currently in the game or were previously in the game for a long time that just leave me wondering how. As of recording this video, there is now a bug that will simply prevent you from freeing teammates as a survivor or capturing people as the beast, and the only known way of fixing it is changing your outfit. Despite all of my complaints though, I still find myself coming back to flee the facility time and time again. It's just too addicting. Playing with your friends is what really makes this game worth coming back to. The concept is simple, yet very engaging. Yes, it definitely needs to be fleshed out more, because everything feels extremely unfinished, but it's clear that this is a great game in the making. With this feedback taken into consideration, I really think Flee the Facility can become so much more than it already is.
So there are my thoughts on Flee the Facility. You know, I may have been really critical of it, but I still love it, I guess. I guess you could say I have a love-hate relationship with this game, which is a lot more on the love side than the hate side, so I guess it's like a love-love-hate relationship, but whatever, you get what I'm trying to say. This game, despite all my criticisms, gets a solid, you know, good old-fashioned thumb for me. Make of that what you will, I guess. And that means...
your life has been spared.
Hey guys, thanks for watching another normal review with nothing different or interesting about it. I'm just talking so I won't get copyright striked for this music. Bye.